Hello friends, welcome back. So in this session we will learn JUnit exception test case and JUnit collections assertion. So in the last session, so far how many test cases we have seen? But if you see our data repository class, and inside this data repository class, that get object, it is throwing some exception also. Suppose if this ID, if we are sending this ID as a null without any value, null with the null reference, if we are calling, it is throwing one exception. And inside this test cases, if you see inside this data repository test case, if you see, we are checking assertion not null, or assertion not null or something we are checking. We are not, or we can check assertion equal, assertion not equal, assert false, assert true, something like that. But suppose if this method itself is throwing exception, this method get object, while calling this get object, and if I will give here null, then definitely this method itself will throw exception here. It will not reach to this line. If I run this one, you will see this test case is failed now. Yes, it's a failure. Why it is failure? It is saying here my custom exception ID cannot be null. So it is throwing that exception, but we are checking with assert null. So from this line itself, it is throwing that exception. So for that exception case, how we can write the exception, that we have to see here. Yeah, now it will be passed. Okay, now this test case is passed because this condition is satisfying. So exception test case is required when expected output is an exception. Before it was the expected output was what? This data object should not be null. They should not be null. That was expected, and it is this result we are getting as per expectation, and so this test case is passing. But if the expected output is an exception, in exception, then what we have to do? So in previous test cases, we have seen that we can use assertion to compare the result of method to expected result with the actual value. But in case method is throwing exception, instead of returning the result set, your method will throw an exception. So for that exception, how we can write the test cases? To write the test cases for exception, we can write that annotation as following: @test. This is same only. @test. This is same only. But under this test case, under this annotation, one variable is defined with expected. Expected, that is nothing but a type. What type of exception you are expecting, you can tell here. In that case, what will happen? If this method will throw that expected exception, this test case will be considered as passed. Otherwise, it will be failed. So where we have written this one? We have written the test case into data repository test 3. Here you can see expected. This is the expected. If you see, I think this one. So this will be. Now this test case will be passed because inside this test annotation we are telling our custom exception to test case that we are expecting this exception. If this exception is coming, then it is a fine. But if you see this get object is throwing two type of exception. One is my custom exception, another one is exception also. This is because of reflection we are giving, because we are using here some reflection code. So you can ignore this one currently, you no need to worry about that one. But this is very important, my custom exception. Here when we are throwing this my custom exception, this custom exception is thrown when id is null. When id is null, we are making comparison here. If it is a null, then we are throwing our exception. So in that case, what will happen? This test case will be passed because here we are telling my custom exception. If suppose if your method is returning it is throwing multiple type of exception, like array index out of bound exception, null pointer exception, arithmetical exception, or any other type of exception, if it is throwing, then you have to write separate test cases. Under that one, you can go for the different type of exception check. So if I run this one here, currently this downside I will ignore here. Okay, so if I run this one, you will see this test case will be passed. Yes, now this is passing, it's not failing, it's passing here. Test case 1, even test case 2. Test case 1 is written for when id is 00, id 001, then this is calling, and this one is when id is null. So these two test cases we have given. So this is the use, how we can give the expected output, how we can specify the result as an expected output, and we can write our test case for the method that is throwing the exception. And here type you can replace with any of the classes. Suppose this can be null pointer exception, array index out of bound exception, or any other custom exception. Any type of exception class you can give here, but that should be the type of class only, exception only. Generally, if it is not a class you will give some other, then it will throw error. You cannot give that one also. Suppose if I give here string, that is also class, but if you see here, it is giving compilation error itself here. What it is saying, type mismatch cannot convert from class of string to class of throwable, because string class is not the subtype of throwable, that is not the type of throwable, so you cannot give that one. But this class is my custom exception is the subtype of throwable. How? Because we are extending exception, and that this exception is again extending throwable only. So you can say that my custom exception is throwable. So you can specify that. So you can say that also, this type you can replace with any throwable type reference dot class. So this is the this is the way how you can write the test case for exception when your method is throwing the exception. Okay, so the next one is collection assertion. What is collection assertion? Suppose in the last sessions or in the second session of J unit, we have seen the assertion. What we checked there, we are writing assert dot assert not null, assert equal, if you see here, array util 2 or array util 1, if you see here, assert equal, assert array equal, assert false, assert, okay, yeah, so these are there, assert equal, assert array equal, assert false, assert not null. So assert null or assert not null, like that we are checking the asserts. But here what you are observing, here only we are specifying either primitive type or any other reference type, but we have not checked for the collection type object. How? Suppose if this method is returning one collection. Collection means that can be a list of some type, that can be a list of student or list of string, list of number, any type. So from that list, if we want to check whether particular element is there or not, then only we will say that this test is passed, otherwise that test is failed. So that type of assertion check is called collection assertion. We can write the assertion for collection also same as how we have written for primitive or reference type in previous sessions. The assertion for collection can be written as following. Assert that actual. Here we have to give core matcher ABC. That ABC can be replaced with any action. That it depends whether we are checking for has item, has size, is size contained, something like that. Like that. Is core matcher is means. Here you will give specify other list. This list is this list. So that is used to test the equality of two list. Has items means this item, this value. This value is present into this actual list or not. To test if the list has the particular value or not. Has size or is. It means you can check whether the size of list is a particular size or it is something differing from that one. Or here contain A, B or C. Ensure that the list has these same order and all the element. And here contain as any order. Here also this and this same only, but here you will see order can be anything, but these elements should be present. So that is ensuring that whether the elements are present into this list or not, or in this collection or not. Order can be anything. Not means to check if list is empty or something like that. Okay, so this one how we can use assert that method we have to use in this case. So if you see, we have written one more method into our data repository. If you see here, this is our data repository. Previously in data repository we have only one method, get object, where we are passing id and type of a class and it is returning of that type object. But now we have written one more method, get objects, that always is returning list of string type with field name, that is nothing but a string value. For this one we are checking what is the name. If field is null or blank means empty without having any value. Even if you give here space also, then also it will be blank only. Okay, so if it is a blank or null, then you can say field cannot be null or field cannot be empty. That's any message you can give. And otherwise it will enter here, and here it is creating one list. If field name you are giving as a city, then it will return the name of city means Delhi, Chandigarh, Mumbai, Chennai, Bhagyanagar. So these are the list of city. And if you are giving field name as a country, then it is giving the list of country name, some name of country like India, Sri Lanka, Burma, Nepal, USA, Russia. So these for these 5-6 country name it is returning. That's it. It's very simple code. You can observe. If it is a city, then it is reading these 5 cities name. If it is a country, then it is reading these 5 countries name, 6 countries name. Okay, so here just we have written this very simple method, that is get object with the it is getting the get object is returning a list of string based on the field name. What is the field name? If you are giving city, then it is returning 5 city name. If you are giving this field name as a country, then it is returning 6 country name. That's it. And here we have written the test case for this one. You can see here, currently we ignored that one, so you remove this one. So if you observe this one, what we are doing here, get objects, and the method name is get objects. So if this is get objects, though it is returning one list of a string type, and that list of string type we are checking for assertion. That collections we are checking for assertion. Assert that means this list has item Delhi. If this list has item Delhi, then only this test case will be passed as considered as passed, otherwise this test case is failed. So currently you see this test case is passed, no failure. Here you can see is a green symbol. Okay, like that you can check for other also, has size. If it is has size something like that, is, wait, so many are there, is to test two list, test equality of two list, has item, okay, has size, that is okay. So like that we can check for other also. Suppose here core matcher dot is means it is ensuring that size is check for the size of collection. So now if you see currently, if it is a city, we are passing as a city. So if it is city, then size is what? What is the size? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is there. So we are checking is size. Now if I run this one, you will see this test case also should be passed. Yes. So this is passing. So like that you can check for other also. So many are there. Some of them are available in some other matcher. Currently what we are using here matcher, this is core matcher, and this core matcher is available under org.hamcrest.coreMatcher. Okay, fine. So you can check like this one. But what is the issue we are getting here? This all methods are deprecated. Asset that this method is deprecated. It means you should not use that one. So instead of that one, you can go with Hamcrest matcher directly, like that, in the same way how we have specified here. Org Hamcrest matcher asset, under org.hamcrest.matcher asset is there. Under that one, asset that is available, and that method you can use. Here you can specify actual whatever you are returning from the method, that should be the actual collection, and here we have to give the matcher, Hamcrest matcher. Using this Hamcrest matcher you can use, but this is deprecated, you should not use this one. But still if you want to use, currently that is working fine, no issue. But in the upcoming version, that may be unsupported function or unsupported operation, it may throw exception. So you can avoid this one, and instead of that one you can use directly this matcher asset from Hamcrest package. Okay, and asset that, so this is not deprecated, so you can use like that also, and this also will work fine if you run. Yes, it's passing. Okay, and here one more important thing is, here if you see this parameter should be the actual means what? Whatever we are getting from the method, this is what we are getting from the method, data repository dot get object city. So that after calling this method, we are getting a list of string type, and this list is the actual collection, that is our actual collection. And what we are matcher we are expecting, that we have to give as a second parameter. But in the last session, if you see asset null or asset not null or asset equal, in that case first should be the expected and the second should be the actual. But here if you see, I will open that one, array UTL. If you see this array UTL, this is the expected output and this is the actual result. This first one is the expected result, this is the actual result. But here if you see this is the expected result, this is the actual result. Okay, so these were the collection assertion and JUnit exception test case. Okay, so in the next session we will see parameterized test case, run with parameterized test case. So I hope you like this session. Please subscribe my channel, and we will see you in the next session. Till that, bye bye, and thanks for watching.